Morning to you, my dear brothers and sisters. Indeed, it's a great day for all of us in India. The church rejoices in the Lord for a beloved Mother Teresa, who is a saint today, as whole world is honoring Mother Teresa as a symbol of peace, an angel of peace. On this day, we celebrate even Teacher's Day. My dear brothers and sisters, we all of us are taught by many teachers, and spiritually to enhance, Jesus is our teacher. Let us, in a special way, pray on this day for all these intentions, while remembering all the ashrams of Mother Teresa and all those people who are serving the sick and the needy and all our teachers. We pray even for these intentions, for the soul of Martin D'Souza, offered by Rose and family, for the soul of Raymond Pinto, offered by Regina Fernandez and family, Vinny Gonzalez and family, for the soul of Eric Gonzalez, offered by Concepcion Gonzalez and family, Philip Gonzalez and family, Agnes Fernandez and Anthony Gonzalez and family, for the soul of Raymond Pinto, offered by Vinny Gonzalez and family, for the soul of Francis and Irene DiMello, offered by Annie and Peter Fernandez. For the soul of Philip and Janet DiMello, offered by Peter and Annie Fernandez. For the soul of Dominic Pascal Fernandez, offered by Kevin Fernandez and family. Thanksgiving to Our Lady of Valenkney, offered by Cheryl D'Souza Furtado. Thanksgiving and a special intention for the good health offered by Anthony Gonzalez and family. Invoking the Triune Spirit, my dear brothers and sisters, let us begin this Holy Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we are celebrating the feast day of Saint Teresa of Calcutta, the Virgin and Foundress of Missionaries of Charity, and she is an angel of peace. Today, we will hear in the first reading that Saint Paul is telling us that we at many times may become fools for Christ, no problem, that the Lord sees us as his own glory. Once I remembered an incident, Mother Teresa had gone out to a rich man to ask for some help. And when she was begging for help, the rich man spitted in her arms. And she said then, "The spit which you gave is for me, but give me something for my children who are hungry." Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, at that moment when we read the story, the person felt, when she asked for the beginning, that she was a fool asking for a help for others. But later on, when she kept on begging, he realized that she is someone very different. Maybe at the sight of the people, people may think about us that we are fools. But at the sight of God, you and me are someone special. Mother Teresa has seen everyone who is abandoned, who is sick, who is vulnerable, who has no one, thought that they are someone special for her. And she began to work for her. And she had a vocation within the vocation to take care of such people. Today, we have many ashrams taking care of the sick, the abandoned, and many more other children who have no one. That angel of peace has inspired so many people to serve the world. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, she has raised a lot of hopes for so many people. She is a great inspiration to me and to you. And she kept on inspiring us to serve God and to serve humanity. Today, at this moment of time, my dear brothers and sisters, in the lockdown, there are so many rules coming up. It is for our safety. Today, we need to take care of ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Even Jesus comes and tells us that relationship with God and the people are very much important. Laws are made for our own safety. We need laws, but what is important is saving the lives of others. Today we are called to do so. For the times that we have failed, let us ask pardon and forgiveness and ask His grace that we may serve God and human through the inspiration of Mother Teresa. Let us not together confess our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned. In my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. God, who called the Virgin Saint Teresa to respond to the love of your Son, thirsting on the cross with outstanding charity to the poorest of the poor, grant us, we beseech you, by her intercession, to minister Christ in our suffering brothers and sisters, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 6 to 15. Take Apollos and myself as an example and remember the maxim. Keep to what is written. It is not for you, so full of your own importance, to go taking sides for one man against another. In any case, brother, has anybody given you some special right? What do you have that you not given to you? And if it was given, he can boast as though it was not. It is that you have everything that was you wanted, that you can be rich already in possession of your kingdom, with us left outside. Instead, I wish you were really kings, and we could be kings with you. But instead, it seems to me, God has put us apostles at the end of the parade. With the man sentenced to death, it is true. We men, here we are, fools for the sake of Christ, while you are the learned men in Christ. We have no power, but you are influential. You drink and clothe. We are beaten up and have no homes. We work for our living with our own hands. When we are cursed, we answer with blessing. When we are hounded, we put with it. We are insulted and we answer politely. We are treated as the official of the world, still this day, the scum of the earth. I am saying all this not just to make you ashamed, but to bring you as my dearest children to your senses. You might have thousands of guardians in Christ, but one more than one father, and it was I who brought you the Christ Jesus by preaching the good news. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is close to all who call him.
The Lord is close to all who call him.
The Lord is just in all his ways and loving in all his deeds. He is close to all who call him from their heart. Your response?
The Lord is close to all who call him.
He grants the desires of those who fear him. He hears the cry and he saves them. The Lord protects all who love him, but the wicked he will utterly destroy. Your response?
The Lord is close to all who call him.
Let me speak the praise of the Lord. Let all mankind bless his holy name forever, for ages unending. Your response?
The Lord is close to all who call him.
Gospel acclamation. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. No one can come to the Father except me. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On Sabbath, Jesus happened to be taking a walk through the cornfield, and his disciples were picking ears of corn, rubbing them in their hands and eating them. Some of the Pharisees said, "Why are you doing something that is forbidden on the Sabbath day?" Jesus answered them, "So you have not read what David did when he and his followers were hungry? How he went into the house of God, took the loaves of offering and ate them, gave them to his followers, loaves which only the priests are allowed to eat. And he said to them, 'The Son of Man is the master of the Sabbath.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters, very many times we forget that God is the creator of everything. Everything that we have is from God. We think at times that whatever we have, that we have gained because of our knowledge, our strength, our struggle. My dear brothers and sisters, that's how the rules and regulations come up. And in the lives of the Pharisees and the scribes, the scene was the same. Always wanted to plot against Jesus, wanted to find reasons that he was not okay and the scribes and the Pharisees were all good. The person who came forward to serve the others, who humbled himself to be like you and me, was questioned. A giver of life was questioned, why you and your disciples are doing something different. My dear brothers and sisters, it can happen with us when we forget that Christ and the Lord is the giver of life, who comes ahead to give us that life in abundance. Let us not forget. The Lord is the Lord of Sabbath, the Lord of the world, the Lord of you and me. He has all authority over us, and we are his own creation. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, we have seen a lot of examples. Those people who have opened themselves to the Lord allowed them to grow in grace. Mother Teresa, as we are celebrating the feast on this day, we have seen how she has grown out of nothing, just with of 5 rupees. Today she is serving whole world. It is the grace of God that is flowing through the humanity. It is said, if you and me cannot feed 100 people, at least one we need to feed, which means we need to serve the humanity. As we are celebrating the Teachers' Day in this pandemic, we have seen how teachers are struggling teaching in online because the network do not support, they do not have a proper equipments, and the teaching online for some of them is very new. At my dear brothers and sisters, they are making an effort to teach to our children, and it is a service. We need to respect every teacher. We need to respect all those who are teaching us in many ways. Let us not lose patience. Rather, we respect and encourage them today in this pandemic. We all of us need that encouragement. We all need to give a pushing hand to our teachers. Let us also remember all those teachers who have taught us. Today, you and me are in this position because of our teachers. And Jesus is the best teacher. Whatever we need, He teaches us. We need to dispose ourselves before Him and allow Him to use us. He will train us, He will mend us, He will teach us everything. Let's continue to pray for all the inmates in the ashrams of Mother Teresa and all those people who are serving the humanity and all the teachers. Let's continue to learn from our Lord Jesus. Offertory. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we offer you this bread, the fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we offer you this wine, the fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His church.
Let us pray. Receive, O God, the homage of our humble service, which we present to you on the feast day of Saint Teresa. Grant that by participation in this mystery, our lives may burn with charity and be consumed with zeal for the salvation of souls through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you granted Saint Teresa a sharing in the thirst of your Son dying on the cross, making her a missionary of charity. She took upon herself the rejection of the poor, and placing herself at their service, she radiated the light of your merciful love. And so, with the angels and archangels, with great multitude of saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Godfrey and Stania, bishops and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all gathered here, O Lord. Give us your grace that we may always serve the humanity. And remember, you are the Lord of this Sabbath and our Creator, and everything comes from you. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, and with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints, Saint Mother Teresa, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now together pray to our Heavenly Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all, always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace
be with you all.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Jesus Christ. Not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for me protection in mind and body and a healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world.
Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
शाश्वत अपरंपार प्रभु नो मानी नो वापार एछे भलाई नो भंडार एनी करुणा शाश्वत अपरंपार
एनी करुणा
Let us pray. May the sacred mysteries we have received, O Lord our God, foster within us the fire of charity by which Saint Teresa, with a joyful spirit, served Jesus Christ, your Son, in the poor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let's go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Novena to the Mother of the Forsaken. Mother of the Forsaken, take under your motherly care all those whom the world despises and forsakes. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Advocate before God of the entire Holy Church, protect her in all her needs, and come to the aid of her visible head, our Holy Father, the Pope. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Queen of heaven and earth, and Queen of our India, protect our nation and help our rulers in the happy solution of the problems that confront them today. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Immaculate patroness of these mission lands, spread the mantle of your protection over them and lead all their children to the heart of your divine Son. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Fountain of consolation to all your devoted children, make us always feel the effects of your motherly protection in all things, and more especially now in this favor for which we pray. We know you will obtain it for us from your Son, if it is for our own good, and we leave it confidently in your hands and His. Mayst you above all obtain for us perseverance in the faith and in the love of your divine Son, and do not forsake us now and at the hour of our death. But after this, our exile, show us unto us in heaven the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and the hour of our death. Amen. The Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help and sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, we fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the World Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer me. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, who has designed to bless us with the favor of venerating the Blessed Virgin Mary under the title of the Mother of the Forsaken, and has willed to bestow so much power on her intercession that no one should be abandoned who has recourse to her motherly help, grant, we beseech you, to us, your servants, the privilege that we all who put ourselves under the protection so exalted a mother may never be forsaken by your divine mercy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.